let me take the next step, which is that we have been using, and I think very successfully in Colorado anyway, the whole notion of self-sustainability as a way of saying, okay, fund us through a certain period of time. This will complete the upgrade on our track. This will complete the conversion of the flat top cars. It will fundamentally put us in a position of being able to financially sustain the railroad. And that is a very strong objective, at least for me, because I don't like relying on the taxpayers to keep the railroad viable. It's an onerous task. It's one that's very uncertain, as we all know very well. And so for us to be able to take care of ourselves, I think, is a very strong objective. And the track program is very heavily integrated with that whole notion. My guess is that we're at least three more years beyond 2025, and so we're out to 2028 now before we can actually achieve self-sustainability. And I encourage all of the commissioners to be thinking about the strategy of using self-sustainability as an argument for funding going forward, at least in the near term. It's a moving target. It's one that's dependent on the legislatures, but nonetheless, I think every time we weaken the forecast date or push it out, that jeopardizes our credibility a bit. So I would have to say on capital, I'm disappointed at the impact that COVID has had on us. I don't see how we can recover given the current state of both of the economies, which are at best, they survive. But look at the oil industry in New Mexico, and you can pretty well project that we're not going to get everything that we ask for in the years ahead. You look at Colorado, and I think the likelihood is much better that we will come back to the $1.1 million that we have been receiving. So even 2028 is perhaps pretty much in question. And if it just keeps getting pushed out, our credibility goes down, not proportionally, but inverse proportion in terms of using that argument. So I want us all to sort of take this global view to heart and focus on, well, okay, what, how are we going to survive? In Colorado, we are receiving maybe on the order of $500,000, half of, or less than half of what we had asked for. That's pretty much status quo in my mind. It does not add to our upgrade program very substantially anyway. That $500,000 is not coming out of current general fund money. It was found out of a very special source that basically recapture of unspent capital money from last year. So I don't think we have an easy path, even in Colorado, to getting our funding. And rather, I would suggest the message is quite simply, don't expect the same funding that we have had out of both states, but particularly Colorado, in the near future going forward. I think our capital upgrade program is in jeopardy. I think we won't be shut down by what we have, but we will continue to have slow order in effect along the railroad. We will have wavy track from soggy conditions going forward. These are things that we may have thought were behind us, and they are not. So that's my message.
Dan, it's a message that I embrace, and I think that you're exactly right. That needs to continue to be a focus. And in Colorado, self-sustainability has been an excellent selling point when we're going to the legislature and the governor's office as well. We certainly very much appreciate their support. It's also shows you how critical it was that we bought into this plan and got the funding over the last number of years, because it's only because of this funding that we were able to survive the COVID situation as well as we have. Obviously, it's a struggle and will continue to be a struggle. And self-sustainability is so important, because we don't know when the next COVID event will occur. And we don't want to be relying upon the states to determine our survival. So I'm, as the fellow commissioner, I'm 100% bought in to the concept of continuing the path to self-sustainability as quickly as we can reasonably do that.
Well, ditto for New Mexico as well. So I'd like to turn to back to Eric, talk about our plans for this year for the various trips that we have, and some new stuff too that looks kind of exciting.